There are times when I really wish astronomers could take their advanced modern knowledge of the cosmos and then go back and rewrite all the terminology so it all makes more sense. Like, for example, dark matter and dark energy seem like they're linked. They have the word dark in them. And maybe they are, but really, they're just mysteries. Is dark matter actually matter, or just a different way that gravity works over long distances? Is dark energy really energy, or is it a part of the expansion of space itself? Black holes are neither black nor holes, but that doesn't stop people from imagining them as dark tunnels to another universe. Or the Big Bang, which makes you think of an explosion. Another category that could really use a reorganization is the term nova, and all the related objects that share that term. Nova, supernova, hypernova, meganova, ultranova. Okay, made the last couple up. I guess if you go back to the basics, a nova is a star that momentarily brightens up, and a supernova is a star that momentarily brightens up to death. But the underlying scenario is totally different. As we've mentioned in many videos already, a supernova commonly occurs when a massive star runs out of fuel in its core, implodes, and then detonates with an enormous explosion. There's another kind of supernova, but we'll get to that later. A plain old regular nova, on the other hand, happens when a white dwarf, the dead remnant of a sun-like star, absorbs a little too much material from a binary companion. This borrowed hydrogen undergoes fusion, which causes it to brighten up significantly, pumping up to 100,000 times more energy off into space. Imagine a situation where you've got two main sequence stars, like our sun, orbiting one another in a tight binary system. Over the course of billions of years, one of the stars runs out of fuel in its core, expands as a red giant, and then contracts back down into a white dwarf. It's dead. Sometime later, the second star dies and it expands as a red giant. So now you've got a red giant and a white dwarf in this binary system, orbiting around each other. And material is streaming off the red giant and onto the smaller white dwarf. This material piles up on the surface of the white dwarf, forming a cozy blanket of stolen hydrogen. When the surface temperature reaches 20 million Kelvin, the hydrogen begins to fuse as if it was the core of a star. Metaphorically speaking, its skin catches fire. No, wait, even better, its skin catches fire and then blasts off into space. Over the course of a few months, the star brightens significantly in the sky. Sometimes a star that required a telescope before suddenly becomes visible with the unaided eye, and then it slowly fades again back to its original brightness. Some stars do this on a regular basis, brightening a few times a century. Others must clearly be on a longer cycle because we've only seen them do it once. Astronomers think that there are about 40 novae a year across the Milky Way, and we often see them in other galaxies. The term nova was first coined by the Danish astronomer Tycho Brahe in 1572 when he observed a supernova with his telescope. He called it the Nova Stella, or new star, and the name stuck. Other astronomers used the term to describe any star that brightened up in the sky before they even really understood the causes. During a nova event, only about 5% of the material gathered on the white dwarf is actually consumed in the flash of fusion. Some is blasted off into space, and some of the byproducts of fusion pile up on its surface. And over millions of years, the white dwarf can collect enough material that carbon fusion can occur. At 1.4 times the mass of the sun, a runaway fusion reaction overtakes the entire white dwarf star, releasing enough energy to detonate it in a matter of seconds. So if a regular nova is the quick flare-up of fusion on the surface of a white dwarf star, then this event is a supernova, where the entire star explodes from a runaway fusion reaction. You might have guessed, this is known as a type 1a supernova. And astronomers use these explosions as a way to measure distance in the universe, because they always explode with the same amount of energy. Huh, I guess the terminology isn't so bad after all. Nova is a flare-up, and a supernova is a catastrophic flare-up to death. That works. So now you know, a nova occurs when a dead star steals material from a binary companion and undergoes a momentary return to the good old days of fusion. A type 1a supernova is the final explosion when a white dwarf has gathered its last meal. We're still working our way through all the exotic stars and astrophysics in the universe, so what would you like to know next? Let me know in the comments. In our next episode, we wonder if you can get space madness. Oh, and make sure you stick around for the blooper. I'd like to thank Ethan Edwards, Joel Goodman, David Young, and the rest of our 624 patrons for their generous support. If you love what we're doing and want to help out, head on over to patreon.com/universetoday. One of the stars runs out of fuel in its core, expands as a red giant, and then contracts back down.